Baxter Van West from AirVenture 2017. Blue Origin is here with their historic new Shepard booster, which was the first booster rocket to land from space. They also have a mock-up capsule. Let's take a closer look at their system.
Blue Origin's new Shepard rocket consists of two parts, the booster and the capsule. The booster on display here has actually flown 5 times, and it shows. There are scorch marks around the base of the rocket, and the heat shielding at the base of the rocket shows ablation, which is the vaporization of the shield to shed heat. The capsule on display is a mock-up, normally be mounted on the top of the booster at launch. The BE-3 engine on the base of the rocket carries both the capsule and the booster up to 75 kilometers, or 237,600 feet, before the two separate. Space officially begins at 100 kilometers, also known as the Kármán line. With the booster hitting 100.5 kilometers and the capsule reaching 103 kilometers, both are technically reflyable spacecraft. Maximum G-loading during ascent is 3 Gs. The booster re-enters the atmosphere first, performing a powered landing. Then the capsule enters the atmosphere, descending first under 3 parachutes, then to a touchdown using a small retro rocket system. Maximum G-loading during ascent is a bit stiffer at almost 5 Gs. The new Shepard capsule has room enough to comfortably seat 6. After separation, the passengers would experience microgravity for 4 minutes. One wonders whether or not it would be a complete chaos with all 6 passengers unstrapped and bouncing around at once. Fortunately, the walls are padded. The view should be fantastic through the capsule's 6,000 square inches of window. That's 1/3 of the capsule's surface area. The whole flight of the capsule from liftoff to landing takes about 11 minutes. Virgin Galactic's Spaceship Two ride is $250,000. Blue Origin didn't say how much the new Shepard ride would cost, but due to its connection with Jeff Bezos, you might be able to purchase your ticket on Amazon.